My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberto with AV Ultra, and today we're going to be taking a look at screen replacements using Mocha in After Effects. For example, piece of footage that is courtesy of Flip 11, what we're going to do is replace this screen off of this phone with whatever we want. In my example here, I am going to be including a piece of footage, but you can use this same technique to replace any screen that you want. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that in. And the first thing I'm going to do is make a comp the size of my original footage. And the reason for that is so that way it is going to fill my screen completely. There are a couple different ways that we could track this. We could be using the point trackers and a perspective tracker like we covered in another lesson here all about trackers. But for today, we're going to jump into Mocha. Mocha has been included with After Effects since 2007 in CS4. So to track something in Mocha, we're going to click on our footage that we want to track, come up to animation, and we're going to track in Mocha AE. Once you start up Mocha, it's going to ask you some different questions. None of this is going to be too important for what we're doing right now. If you're using a lot of tracking, I definitely recommend checking this out. The only thing that we're concerned about right now is to make sure our frame rate matches, our pixel aspect ratio matches, and we hit our advanced and cache our clip. So let's go ahead and start tracking. I'm going to click on this X-Spline tool. The way this X-Spline tool works is every time I click, it is going to make a point. And if I right click, it's going to close the point. In After Effects, I might want to click on these individual points to track. But the way that Mocha works is it is a planar tracker, which means it is going to try and figure out everything that sits in this plane. So now that we have this click, 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 right click to close, you can see I have my layer one. And I'm starting at the first frame, and I'm going to come down here to the tracking panel. I'm just going to go ahead and track forward. As I track forward, let's take a look at some of the other options down here. If we're doing a lot of just translation, meaning X and Y coordinate tracking, we're going to want this click. If something is scaling, we're going to want this click. If there's a bit of rotation, which there isn't some here, we're going to want that as well as shear. This is on by default. However, the more that you click, the more it has to process. So if you're only doing translation and scale, just click those two as opposed to all of them. It's not necessarily going to give you a better track if you are clicking it and don't need it. Could be giving it too much information. So now this is just about done. We can play this back and forth and check out our track. So you may be thinking, okay, I have this plain track. Do I really need it this loose? And the answer is, yeah, you do want it this loose. You don't necessarily want it on those points. So how can I get this screen cut out to work in After Effects? We're going to come up here to our actual planar surface. And that's this button right here. Next to that, we also have our planar grid. I'm going to go ahead and click both of these. So first the planar surface. You can see that we've gotten this box. And then our planar grid. I'm going to turn that off for right now. We're going to come back to that. And now let's take a look at this box here. So you'll notice that I have these four points. If I click on a single point and drag it, if you take a look at the top left part of my window, that is a zoom in of this pixel that I'm going to be tracking to. Same with this side. So what I'm going to do is just kind of square this up fairly perpendicular. And we should have 1, 2, 3, and 4. If I scroll back and forth, you'll notice that those points are locked directly onto those corners. The reason for that, it is using the tracking information it got from this shape here. If I play this back, you'll notice that this grid is perfectly in line with this rectangle that I've already set up here. So if I drag this to, let's say, out here, you'll notice that this planar grid is off in another dimension. For giggles here, I'm not going to be tracking, but I'm just going to take these four points to this lamp that we have. And now you can see that that is the plane of which that lamp is sitting on. Now, it's probably not going to track that well because it wasn't tracked to that point, but that's actually not too bad considering that they're both residing in somewhat of the same plane. So I'm going to undo that here really quick. And there we go. And I'm going to turn off my planar grid. Now we have most of the information that we need to turn this into a corner pin in After Effects. So what I'm going to do is come down to export tracking data, and I'm going to click this, and I'm given a few options. Currently, because I'm using the bundled version of Mocha, we only have a few different options here. We have one that supports corner pin only, RG warp and Mocha import, or one that supports motion blur. I'm gonna go ahead and just pick this corner pin only, and we're gonna copy this to the clipboard. Now I'm gonna leave this open in the background, and I'm just gonna flip back to After Effects. The next thing I'm gonna do is figure out what I wanna put in this screen. It'd be great if I can just make a drag and drop method, so that's what we're going to do. So let's go ahead and make a solid, and I'm going to call this solid replacement. And now that I have my replacement there, first thing I'm going to do is pre-comp it. And I'm going to call this one the replacement comp. So we have a solid here that's called replacement, and now we have a comp that's called replacement. If I go right to my replacement comp, still in my original comp, my screen replacement, I can just as easily go to the first frame and hit Control V, and that is going to paste that corner pin data. So if I play this back, you can see that it's tracked pretty well. We do have a slight issue here. So if I zoom in around 200%, we can see a little bit of spill, and we're going to clean that up in a second. But let's go ahead and replace this screen. I'm gonna go ahead and lock this comp, and I'm gonna make use of my edit this, look at that. This will let us change the comp on the fly and see the direct result as we're replacing it. I've locked this comp, and I'm just going to go ahead and click this one as well. That is going to open that secondary comp in here. I'm gonna lock that one as well and just give myself a little bit more room. Now that we're in this replacement comp, I'm gonna go ahead and drag in a piece of footage that I wanna replace with. If I play this guy back, you can see this is what I'm gonna be replacing it with. And we'll go ahead and close that. And I'm gonna go ahead and drag that right into my composition. Now you'll notice my original was done for a vertical screen, and my other screen is horizontal. That's pretty important because if I come back into my comp here, you can see what's happening. So let's go ahead and work on this a little bit. I'm in my replacement comp, and all I'm going to do is just squish down this piece of footage to fill the edges of my comp. So you can see right there, I've gone just a little bit beyond there. I could probably even just transform, fit to comp. And now that is perfectly lined up with those corner pin points. So let's go ahead and close this for right now. And let's continue to work with this. I'm gonna bump up my exposure control here just so I can really take a look at how much bleed there is here. And I can see there is a significant amount of bleed from that blue screen that we had originally for tracking. For future reference, you don't necessarily need a very bright blue screen if you're gonna be doing some Mocha replacements. Pretty much anything will work as long as you can see where the edge of the screen is. In fact, in my experience, I like a fairly gray area just so that way I can corner pin it a little bit easier and not have to worry about this spill. In our situation here, we want to suppress the spill as much as possible. So back in my Mocha screen replacement, we have our replacement comp, and that's what we have here. And then we have our original. I'm just gonna come down to my effects and pull up the spill suppressor. I'm just using the obsolete one, and I'm gonna place that right onto my comp. And just like magic, right away, it's removed all that blue. By default, the color that it wants to suppress is blue, but if there's another color, let's say this guy, you'll see it's trying to suppress that. And in our case right here, this works out perfectly. In fact, I might wanna dial this back just a tiny bit so it doesn't remove all the excess blue in our scene. We have that pretty cleaned up. Let's turn off our exposure control, and it is very clean now. The last thing I might wanna do is actually roughen up this image just a little bit, so that way it blends in with the grain of the rest of the scene. So there you go, a simple way to both replace the screen in any kind of moving footage, and even suppress a bit of that spill. My name is Stanislav Robert Liberta with AV Ultra. Hopefully you found this information useful. Thanks a lot for watching.